Hello everybody and welcome you all to the YouTube channel of Arihant Academy. I am Smriti Nayak, who is the head of the geometry department in the school section of Arihant Academy, and today I am here in front of you to guide you about the CET for the college admissions. So I'll be talking to you today about the geometry part of the CET content, and the geometry of the CET content can be broadly divided into two categories. One is entirely based on proofs and theorems, and the other is based on formulas and its applications. Now, today in front of you on your screen, you can see the topic, which is similarity and Pythagoras theorem. Both these topics are based on proofs, theorems, and the concepts. It's a concept-based chapter. So without much ado, without taking your time now, I'll immediately start with the first topic, which is similarity. Now, you've already done a little of similarity in your 9th standard, in your 10th standard also, so you are aware what it is all about. So I take you further now. Now, you can see the header, points to remember. And the first header here is basic proportionality theorem. In short, which I will call as BPT. So, in BPT, you only need to listen or to watch out for two things. सबसे पहले तो आपके पास एक ट्राइंगल होना चाहिए, which you can see in the diagram over here. ट्राइंगल दिख रहा है आपको, and there should be two parallel lines. So you can clearly see over here, DE is parallel to BC. So the moment these two are clear to you, without any blinking of an eyelid, you can think of basic proportionality theorem. So see here, let me check this out for you. If in triangle ABC, simultaneously please look at the diagram also. So if in triangle ABC, seg DE is parallel to side BC, then what is the formula which we get? The formula we get is AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC. Means the ratio AD upon DB will be proportional to the ratio AE upon EC. This is your formula of basic proportionality theorem. Now that we've understood this concept, let us immediately take an MCQ based on this concept. So the first MCQ in front of you. In the given figure, okay, so figure mein two things I told you to check. Sabse pehle triangle hai kya? Yes, so ye point to clear ho gaya. Second, DE parallel to BC bhi bola gaya hai, means both the pointers are ready for us. So instead of any thinking, I know I am going to use BPT, that is basic proportionality theorem. Okay, so I know at the back of my mind, my formula is going to be AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC. The same formula which I showed you on the previous screen. Now, let me check what are the other things given to me in the question. They've told me AB is 12. Okay, so AB is 12 means this entire AB is going to be 12. And they've told me AD is 3. Matlab this part here is going to be 3. So obviously from common sense, I know that if the entire part is 12 and a little part of it is 3, by betweenness, the remaining part is going to be 9. So now I'm ready to solve my ratio. So AD upon DB will be nothing but, AD upon DB will be nothing but 3 upon 9 is equal to AE upon EC. A very simple, I easily know my answer. AE upon EC is going to be 1 upon 3, 1 upon 3, which is nothing but AE is to EC is equal to 1 is to 3. So I'm very clear, my answer is my option B, and I'm done with this MCQ. So this is how we'll be applying the basic proportionality theorem formula. Alright, so let's get ahead now. Okay, now we come to the second pointer here, which is converse of basic proportionality theorem. Now, in simple English, the meaning of converse would be to speak to talk, to strike a conversation with somebody. But in geometry, the meaning of converse is opposite, reverse, ulta. So check out here over now. If in triangle ABC, AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC, then what? Sec DE is parallel to side BC. तो हमने BPT में पढ़ा था that in a triangle if two sides are parallel तो the ratios are in proportion. इसमें उसका उल्टा है. इसमें they are telling us that if the ratios are in proportion then I can say that sec DE is parallel to side BC. Exact opposite of BPT is the converse. Alright, so time for the MCQ now. So in triangle PQR, if PS upon SQ is equal to PT upon TR, then dash. Four options in front of you. In case if you're comfortable, I would advise without drawing the diagram, try to visualize it in your mind and you will easily come to the conclusion that option A is your answer. Still, if some of you are unable to do it visually in your mind, you need the diagram to be drawn, so let me help you out with that also. So I'll just draw a triangle here. They've told me P, Q, R is the triangle. And somewhere there is a segment such that PS, this is S and this is T. So ratio kya hai? Dekho, PS upon SQ aayega na, is equal to PT upon TR. This is when if I apply the BPT. So this is the converse now. So if this ratio is equal, they've told me this ratio is equal. So automatically this is going to be my option. Alright. So if you are sorted with this much, let's get ahead now. Now we come to the third concept of this chapter, which is ratio of areas of two triangles. I repeat, ratio of areas of two triangles. So the first, which is the parent formula, the original formula, which is A1 upon A2, dekho, ratio of areas hai na, to dekho, A1 upon A2 aaya, is equal to B1 into H1 upon B2 into H2, where A1, B1, H1 stand for the dimensions of the first triangle and A2, B2, H2 for the second triangle. And in the bracket, let me read out the sentence for you. So, ratio of areas of two triangles is equal to what? Ratio of the product of their corresponding bases and heights. तो जो भी यहाँ पे formula में लिखा हुआ है, same यहाँ पे आपको bracket में मैंने read करके सुना दिया. Now, I told you first was the original formula, the parent formula. From that, we have derived the second and the third formula. So, let's give our attention now to the second formula, which is A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2. Means you must have realized in the second formula, H1 upon H2 gayab ho gaya. Under what condition will it disappear? So, let me read the bracket. Ratio of areas of two triangles with equal heights. See, the emphasis is on equal heights. If the heights are equal, obviously H1, H2 cut ho jayega. To aapke paas kya reh jayega? B1 upon B2. That is your formula. So, reading the bracket again. Ratio of areas of two triangles with equal heights is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases. Alright? Now, the third formula is derived again from the parent formula. मतलब first formula में से हमने अभी third formula derive किया है, which you can see in front of you now, the third one. A1 upon A2 is equal to H1 upon H2. Obviously you must have understood over here कि इसमें bases cut हो गए. तो see in the bracket, ratio of areas of two triangles with equal bases is equal to ratio of their corresponding heights. तो अगर bases equal हैं तो B1, B2 cut हो जाएगा, आपको मिलेगा H1 upon H2. So quickly to run through, the first one, A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 into H1 upon B2 into H2. Second, A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2. What is the condition? When the heights are equal. Third formula, A1 upon A2 is equal to H1 upon H2. and the condition applied is when the bases are equal. So I'm sure the three points are clear to you. So tackling now the MCQ. Okay, so see the third MCQ in front of you. In the adjoining figure, area of triangle PQS upon area of triangle RQS is equal to dash. So let me highlight the diagram for you. So PQS is my blue triangle over here. Okay. And RQS is going to be my inverted triangle over here. And you can see that they both are sharing something common. Dekho, PQS and RQS, they are joined to each other. Where are they joined? They are joined at QS, which means the two triangles are sharing a common base. So aapka formula hoga area 1 upon area 2. Area 1 upon area 2 is nothing but height 1 upon height 2. Ab height kaun sa hai upar wale triangle ka? The height is nothing but PM. You can see the perpendicular symbol over here. So that indicates the height. And the height of the second triangle, the inverted triangle, is nothing but RN. So I got my answer. My answer is my option A. Easy, right? So there's nothing to worry. You only need to focus and then the confidence is what will help you out. Okay, so let's move ahead now. Okay, we come now to the fourth MCQ, which is based on the same property. In the adjoining figure, line L parallel to line M. Now, this is extremely important. There is a hidden meaning over here. They are telling us line L is parallel to line M. Check the diagram. Now, whenever two lines are parallel to each other, one thing is very clear in my mind. They will have equal heights in between them because parallel lines are equally placed. Now, so the distance between them is going to be the same, which means the height is going to be the same. So obviously, mere dimag mein formula baith jata hai A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2 because, as I said, heights are equal. So a PQS jo hai, which is, you can see my red color triangle over here, ye hai mera PQS. And coming to the other triangle, which is TRS. So TRS, you can see, is my yellow color triangle over here. तो ये रेड और जो येलो ट्राइंगल है अपार्ट फ्रॉम द फैक्ट दैट दे शेयर अ कॉमन हाइट रेस्ट नथिंग इज कॉमन तो ऑलरेडी फॉर्मूला तो लिख दिया है बी वन अपॉन बी टू ठीक है सो नाउ व्हाट इज माय बी वन फॉर द फर्स्ट ट्राइंगल बी वन इज गोइंग टू बी क्यू एस एंड फॉर द येलो ट्राइंगल व्हाट इज द बेस इट इज गोइंग टू बी आर एस अब फॉर्मूला डाल दिया अल्फाबेट सब्सटीट्यूट हो गए अब वैल्यू सब्सटीट्यूशन का टाइम आ गया तो क्यू एस इज नथिंग बट दिस एंटायर थिंग एंटायर बेस जो कि 2+3 हमको मिल गया 5 एंड आर एस इज वेरी क्लियरली टोल्ड टू मी दैट इट इज 3 सेंटीमीटर देखो सो दिस विल बिकम 5/3 अब 5/3 कौन सा ऑप्शन है मेरे पास ऑप्शन बी So, I'm done with this MCQ. Fine. So, let's get ahead now. We now come to the next pointer, which is similarity of two triangles. Now, bachas, get it very clear in your mind. Similar and congruent are not the same. When I say congruent, I mean same shape and same size. I repeat, congruent means same shape and same size. But similar means same shape but different sizes and to highlight this see I have made the two diagrams of distinctly different sizes shape same hai but size dekho alag hai ABC you can see is a bigger triangle whereas DEF comparatively is a smaller triangle Okay, so now coming to the explanatory part of it. If in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, angle A is congruent to angle D, you can see the markings in the diagram, similar markings are shown. Angle B is congruent to angle E, again same marking is shown, identical marking for angle B and angle E, and angle C is congruent to angle F. Matlab, if the three pairs of angles are congruent to each other, and what is the next condition, and AB upon DE is equal to BC upon EF is equal to AC upon DF. Matlab, the ratios of the three sides must be in proportion to each other. And in this diagram, what is the proportion? Dekho, ye AB 4 hai aur ye DE 2 hai. So when I substitute here 4 upon 2, I will get 2 upon 1. Theek hai? Ab dekhte hain BC aur EF ka ratio. So see, BC is 6, EF is 3. So ye bhi ratio ho gaya 2 upon 1. Now the last ratio, let us check AC upon DF. So AC 10 hai, DF 5 hai. So ye bhi ho gaya 2 upon 1. So easily I can say my ratios are in proportion. So I can then conclude with all this that triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. Triangle ABC similar to triangle DEF. So this is how we arrive at similarity of the two triangles. Okay, so the fifth MCQ given. Triangle ABC similar triangle DEF. So we are very clear ki ABC triangle jo hai wo DEF triangle ke saath similar hai. Now automatically I will understand कि एंगल ए जो है वो डी के साथ कॉन्ग्रुएंट होगा, बी जो है वो ई के साथ कॉन्ग्रुएंट होगा, एंड सी इज गोइंग टू बी कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू एफ. ओके, नाउ इफ ए इज 45 डिग्रीज, ओके, ई इज 35 डिग्रीज, देन बी इज हाउ मच. सो एब्सोल्युटली नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू डू एनी कैलकुलेशन एट ऑल. Just apply the knowledge which we have just now shared. So we clearly know that B and E are equal to each other. So agar E 35 degrees hai, without any iota of doubt, I know B is also going to be 35 degrees, which is my option B. So if you realize here, angle A, which they have told you is 45, is absolutely unwanted. It is only given to create confusion in your mind. But if you are confident of yourself, confusion to creep hoga hi nahi aapke mind mein. Okay, so we finish this MCQ. Okay, so now taking you to the MCQ based on this concept. Now they've told me that triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. AB is equal to 6, BC is equal to 8, CA is equal to 10, means all the dimensions of the first triangle are given to you, and QR is equal to 6. So apna jo second triangle hai PQR, uska sirf humko QR diya gaya hai. Theek hai? What is the length of PR? They are asking us to find out the value of PR. So let us get on with the calculation part now. So since triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR, this is given to us, so I can say therefore BC upon QR is equal to AC upon PR. I have written the ratio of the corresponding sides. Okay, now let us substitute the values. So BC we know is 8, QR we know is 6, is equal to AC I know is 10, and PR is what I am supposed to be finding out. तो हमने अभी वैल्यूज भी सब्स्टिट्यूट किए. नाउ इट इज बेसिकली जस्ट क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड द कैलकुलेशन पार्ट इट इज रिमेनिंग. सो देयरफॉर पीआर विल बी 10 इनटू 6 अपॉन 8. टाइम फॉर कैंसिलेशंस. सो 2 3 जा 6, 2 4 जा 8, 2 2 जा 4, 2 5 जा 10. सो आई विल गेट माई वैल्यू ऑफ पीआर एज 5 3 जा 15 अपॉन 2, which is nothing but 7.5 centimeter. and 7.5 as I can see is my option number D. So I'm done with this. तो मुझे जो पी आर ढूंढना था वो मुझे मिल चुका है. ठीक है, फाइन. नाउ वी कम टू द फिफ्थ पॉइंट टू रिमेंबर विच इज टेस्ट ऑफ सिमिलैरिटी. अब सिमिलैरिटी हमने कर लिया, अब उसका नेक्स्ट फर्दर प्रोग्रेशन है टेस्ट ऑफ सिमिलैरिटी, इन विच यू कैन सी द फर्स्ट वन विच इज ए ए ए, मतलब ट्रिपल ए टेस्ट, एंड इन टू ब्रैकेट्स आई हैव रिटन ए ए टेस्ट. It simply means that if two pairs of angles are congruent to each other, then automatically the third pair has to be congruent. Uske paas koi option hi nahi bachta. So, if in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, angle A congruent to angle P, you can check the markings also, similar identical markings. Angle B congruent to angle Q, angle C congruent to angle R, then what do I understand? Triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR by the AAA test of similarity. This is called as the triple A test. This was the first test of similarity. Okay, moving on to the second test, which is SAS, matlab side angle side. And very important over here to take notice, the angle should be included between the two pairs of the sides which are in proportion to each other. What I mean is, see, if in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, angle B is congruent to angle Q and AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR, matlab AB upon PQ ka ratio and BC upon QR ke ratio ke beech mein, see, you can see B and Q are the included angles, then I can conclude that triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR by which test? By the SAS test of similarity. Matlab side angle side test of similarity. Okay, moving on to the third and the last test of similarity. There are only three tests. Sabse pehle tha AAA, then we came to the SAS, and now the last is the SSS. Matlab side side side. तो इस डायग्राम में आपको कहीं पे भी एंगल्स का मार्किंग नहीं दिखाई देगा. नाउ इफ इन ट्राइंगल ए बी सी एंड ट्राइंगल पी क्यू आर, ए बी अपॉन पी क्यू इज इक्वल टू बी सी अपॉन क्यू आर इज इक्वल टू ए सी अपॉन पी आर, एंड सी द रेशियोज आर देयर, लेट अस लाइक द वन ऑफ द अर्लियर सम्स, लेट अस चेक, आई कंफर्म दैट विथ यू. देन ट्राइंगल ए बी सी इज सिमिलर टू ट्राइंगल पी क्यू आर बाय द साइड 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 और द एस 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 टेस्ट ऑफ सिमिलैरिटी. So as I was saying, I'll confirm it. So see AB upon PQ, which is going to be 4 upon 6. So ye ho jayega 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. So ratio aaya 2 upon 3. Now I will take you for BC upon QR, which is 10 upon 15. I will take 5 times table here. So fir se aaya 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15. And I take you on to the last ratio, which is AC upon PR, which is 8 अपॉन 12. तो अगर मैं 4 का टेबल लेती हूँ, सो 4 टूज आर 8, 4 थ्रीज आर 12. तो यू कैन सी ऑल योर रेशियोज आर कमिंग इन प्रपोर्शन, 2 अपॉन 3, 2 अपॉन 3, 2 अपॉन 3. तो दिस क्वालिफाइज टू बी एस 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 टेस्ट ऑफ सिमिलैरिटी. तो ऑल द थ्री टेस्ट ऑफ सिमिलैरिटी आर डिस्कस्ड. लेट अस नाउ टेक अ रिलेटेड एमसीक्यू. नाउ इन ट्राइंगल डी ई एफ एंड ट्राइंगल एक्स वाई जेड, DE upon XY is equal to EF upon YZ. मतलब देखो, two sides they're given in proportion. Ratio of two sides is in proportion. DE upon XY is equal to EF upon YZ. And angle E is congruent to angle Y. Do you realize angle E and angle Y, I'll mark it for you, are included between the two pairs of the ratio of the two pairs of sides? So, dash test gives the similarity between triangle DEF and triangle XYZ. Abhi sides in proportion hai aur unka included angle congruent hai. To obviously, ye ban jayega mera SAS test of similarity. Theek hai? Now, we come to the last point of this chapter, which is theorem of areas of similar triangles. As the word suggests, there are two things to be focused on over here. One is area and the second is similar. These two words is what you should look out for when you are reading the MCQs. So, if triangle ABC is similar triangle PQR, matlab I am very clear in my mind that triangle ABC is there and it is similar to triangle PQR. Okay, तो ये similar जो है वो explain हो गया है यहाँ पर. तो this part is done. Then what? Area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle PQR is equal to AB square upon PQ square is equal to BC square upon QR square is equal to AC square upon PR square. This is the formula for it. And in words in the bracket, I have written the explanation. So, I am reading it out. Kindly pay attention. When two triangles are similar, ratio of areas of those triangles is equal to the ratio of the squares of their corresponding sides. I repeat the bracket part again, kindly focus. When two triangles are similar, ratio of areas of those triangles is equal to the ratio of the squares of their corresponding sides. So, ye hai hamara last concept of this chapter, which is theorem of areas of similar triangles. I hope you are clear with this. And now taking on its MCQ. If triangle ABC is similar triangle PQR. So I told you two things to bear in mind. Sabse pehle hai area and similar. To dekho similar to unhone humko bata diya hai, indicate kar diya hai. So, and AB is to PQ is equal to 3 is to 4. Then area of triangle ABC is to area of triangle PQR is equal to how much? तो देखो similar तो already आ चुका था और अभी area का भी जिक्र हो रहा है तो obviously ये होगा मेरा concept 6 which is TOAST theorem of areas of similar triangles. Okay, so what is the formula going to be? It will be area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle PQR is equal to, out of the three ratios I can take any one, and which one will I take? Obviously the one jiska mujhe value diya gaya hai. So this will become AB square upon PQ square. Now AB is to PQ, they've told me, is 3 upon 4 the whole square. So this will be nothing but 3 square upon 4 square, which is very clearly known to me is 9 upon 16, because 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16. So my answer will be, therefore area of triangle ABC is to area of triangle PQR is equal to 9 is to 16. Okay, you can see it here, 9 is to 16, which is my option B. And I'm done with my MCQ. Easy, right? Only you have to put your formula, you have to substitute, you have to simplify, and you get your answer. Your MCQ is sorted. Alright? Now, area of two similar triangles are 18 cm square and 32 cm square respectively. So, isme to dono hi words aa gaye. First sentence mein hi area bhi aa gaya, similar bhi aa gaya. So, obviously, I'm going to use theorem of area of similar triangles. Now, the question is asking me, what is the ratio of their corresponding sides? What is the ratio of their corresponding sides is what I need to find out. Now, the triangles are not labeled here ABC, PQR, kuch bhi nahi hai. So, it's entirely your prerogative what you decide to take. So, I will simply call it as A1 upon A2 is equal to side 1 square upon side 2 square. I'm not taking A, B, P, Q, nothing. Just side 1 upon side 2. Okay? So, now A1 upon A2, they've given me is 18 upon 32 is equal to side 1 square upon side 2 square. Now, 18 and 32, I need to cancel it. So, I need to check which table goes in them. So, I will take the easiest, which is 2 times. So, 2 9s are 18 and 2 16s are 32. So, mujhe milta hai side 1 square upon side 2 square is 9 upon 16. But I don't want the squares, na? I want the ratio of the corresponding sides. So obviously, very simply, I know side 1 upon side 2 will be 3 upon 4. 3 upon 4 is nothing but 3 is to 4, which is my option A. Alright, so with this we have completed all the MCQs, all the concepts based on our first topic under consideration, which was similarity. Theek hai? So I hope if there was any hesitation or any sort of fear in your mind or whatever, we've dispelled it from your minds now. Okay, so let's now move on to the second chapter which I will be talking about today, which is Pythagoras theorem. A very simple topic, extremely easy and very small topic. So first concept here is Pythagoras theorem, which probably we learnt maybe way back in the 5th or the 6th standard. So if in triangle ABC angle B is 90 degree, the diagram shows you very clearly angle B is 90, then AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square, means the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the remaining two sides. This is my Pythagoras theorem. Now, the 10th MCQ, a man goes 9 meter due east and then 14 meter due north. Matlab, there is a person who is starting to walk from a particular point. First he goes to the east. Once he reaches 9 meters, he goes to the north. So you need to visualize this. You need to just you need to figure it out. Or you want, you can just draw a small rough diagram for it. So I'll simply take a very small diagram over here. So this is the starting point. This is the starting point, which is A. Theek hai? From A, the man is walking towards the east direction, which means he is walking this way and he comes to B, and this is 9 meters. Now after reaching B, he turns and then he walks 40 meters to the north, means he is now going upwards. Theek hai? So I will have to draw this as my C and this is 40 meters, and don't forget the very basic thing ki B to 90 degree hoga. Now the question is, how far is he from the starting point? So starting point uska A tha. A mein se chalkar wo B tak gaya, B se wo upar C tak gaya. To ab aapko dhoondna hai A aur C ke beech ka distance kitna hai. So I put a question mark because I need to find it out. Okay, so now this is my Pythagoras theorem. So my Pythagoras formula will be over here. AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So AB is 9 square, BC is 40 square, 9 square is 81, 40 square is 1600. When you add both, you will get 1681, which is your AC square. Theek hai? So automatically your AC will be 41 meters because you've taken the root. And if you are comfortable with the Pythagorean triplets, we clearly know 9, 40 and 41 make a triplet. So if 9 and 40 are given to you and hypotenuse is what you need to find, you need not even do this calculation part. You can straight away skip all this because you can orally know your answer is going to be 41 meters. Okay, so this is my option C. Now we come to the second concept, which is converse of Pythagoras. Ab thodi der pehle hi maine aapko bola tha, converse in geometry means the exact opposite. So if in triangle ABC AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square, then angle ABC is 90 degree. In the earlier concept we said if the angle is 90, then this is the formula. Okay, now we are saying if this is the formula which is applicable, then the angle B has to be a right angle. This is my converse of Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so a very simple MCQ. If PQR are sides of a triangle and if P square plus Q square is equal to R square, the focus should be over here. P square plus Q square is equal to R square, then the triangle will be dash. So this highlight which I have done over here clearly tells me that the square of the one side is equal to the sum of the squares of the remaining two sides. तो ये कौन से ट्राइंगल में फिट बैठता है, ये तो राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल में फिट बैठता है ना, सो माई आंसर विल बी ऑप्शन बी, राइट एंगल. सो देर इज नो कैलकुलेशन रिक्वायर्ड एट ऑल, इट इज ओनली बाई ऑब्जर्वेशन यू नीड टू गेट दिस MCQ. ओके, सो नाउ द थर्ड कंसेप्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर विच इज 30-60-90 थियरम, एंड द डायग्राम एट द साइड इज क्लियरली इंडिकेटिव ऑफ वॉट आई सेड, where A you can see is 30 degree, B is C is 60 degree and B is 90 degree. So one angle is 30, other is 60, other is 90. So what happens in such a case? So if in triangle ABC angle B is 90 degrees, angle A is 30 degrees, angle C is 60 degrees, then BC is equal to half AC. And it is in the bracket written side opposite to 30 degrees. Means it simply means कि अगर कोई angle हमारा 30 degree है तो उसका जो opposite side होता है which over here you can see is BC. तो BC ढूंढने के लिए what formula will I take? I will take the formula BC is equal to half of the hypotenuse which is half AC. Okay? Now, we come to the second part of the formula. AB is equal to root 3 upon 2 AC. And this formula is used for side opposite to 60 degrees. So, let me explain it in the diagram for you. Dekho, my angle C is 60. Ab 60 ka opposite side kaun sa hai? AB hai. To agar mujhe AB ka value dhoondna hai, my formula will be root 3 upon 2 into the hypotenuse which is AC. So these are my two formulae of 30-60-90 theorem. I repeat, to find out the value of side opposite 30 degrees, jo bhi aapka hypotenuse hoga, uska half le lo. And to find the value of the side opposite 60 degrees, aapko jo bhi hypotenuse ka value hai, usko root 3 upon 2 se multiply karna hota hai. That is how you get your answers. Okay? So moving on, the 12th MCQ. In triangle ABC, angle B is 90 degrees, angle C is 30 degrees. So the moment they tell me the measure of two angles, B mujhe pata hai 90 hai, C mujhe pata hai 30 hai. Obviously, A ke paas to koi chara hi nahi hoga. A has no option at all. A will have to be 60 degrees. To ye ban gaya mera 30-60-90 triangle. 30-60-90 theorem abhi use kar payenge. Now, they have told me AB is 6 cm. AB is 6 cm, which I am writing here. Then, AC is equal to how much? Matlab, mujhe abhi hypotenuse ko dhoondna hai. So, I will use the formula for side opposite 30 degrees. And I know the formula for side opposite 30 degrees, AB is equal to half of AC. We have discussed this formula. Now, AB I know is 6 is equal to half of AC. So simply now I will multiply AC is equal to 6 into 2 which is going to be 12. So I get my option as D. So AC is going to be 12 centimeter. And my MCQ is done. I told you nothing to fear. It's all very simple. Okay, now we come to the fourth pointer which is 45-45-90 theorem. So, agar ek angle hamara 45 degree hai, dusra bhi 45 hai aur teesra 90 hai. So, it qualifies as a 45-45-90 triangle and I can use over here 45-45-90 theorem. And also to draw your attention, let me just take you to the sides. Ab dekho, AB और BC को मैंने identical marking किया है, means दो sides equal हैं, तो ये isosceles triangle बन गया, and one angle is 90, तो ये बन जाता है isosceles right angle triangle. तो 45-45-90 triangle can also be understood to be a 45-45-90 triangle, can also be understood to be an isosceles right angle triangle. ठीक है, आई रिपीट 45-45-90 ट्राइंगल अगर आपको आता है तो ऑटोमेटिकली योर ब्रेन शुड स्टार्ट थिंकिंग कि दिस इज ऑल्सो एन आइसोसेलिस राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल. एंड फॉर्मूला क्या है तो देखो, ए बी इज इक्वल टू बी सी इज इक्वल टू 1/√2 AC. तो ए बी ढूंढो या बी सी ढूंढो, दोनों तो एक ही हैं, इक्वल हैं दोनों. इट विल बी 1/√2 AC. नाउ टाइम टू डील विद द MCQ. इन एन आइसोसेलिस राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल, कम ऑन स्टार्ट थिंकिंग. आइसोसेलिस राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल बोला है तो ऑटोमेटिकली वॉट शुड फ्लैश? 45-45-90. ठीक है, तो वी आर सॉर्टेड विद दिस. नाउ लेट्स रीड फर्दर. इन एन आइसोसेलिस राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल कॉमा डैश थियरम विल बी एप्लीकेबल. तो फटाक से सीधा टिक करो ऑप्शन बी पर. आई टोल्ड यू 45-45-90 इज नथिंग बट आइसोसेलिस राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल. ठीक है, नाउ वी कम टू कंसेप्ट 5 विच इज थियोरम ऑफ ज्योमेट्रिक मीन. आई रिपीट, कंसेप्ट 5 इज थियोरम ऑफ ज्योमेट्रिक मीन. तो द डायग्राम ऑल्सो चेक योर फोकस ऑन दैट एज वेल एज द कंटेंट. इफ इन ट्राइंगल ए बी सी एंगल बी इज 90 degree, तो देखो मुझे दी बी दिख रहा है 90 यहाँ पे. एंड बी डी परपेंडिकुलर हाइपोटेन्यूस ए सी, मतलब बी इज योर राइट एंगल वाला वर्टेक्स. सो फ्रॉम द राइट एंगल वर्टेक्स आई एम गोइंग टू ड्रॉ अ परपेंडिकुलर टू द हाइपोटेन्यूस विच यू कैन सी ओवर हियर इज बी डी इज अ परपेंडिकुलर टू द हाइपोटेन्यूस. ओके, सो इन दैट केस वॉट इज द फॉर्मूला आई गेट? बी डी स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू ए डी इंटू डी सी. मतलब द ज्योमेट्रिक मीन फॉर्मूला टेल्स मी दैट बी डी स्क्वेयर विच इज द परपेंडिकुलर टू द हाइपोटेन्यूस विल बी इक्वल टू द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द टू पार्ट्स इंटू विच इट डिवाइड्स द हाइपोटेन्यूस. मीन्स बी डी स्क्वेयर विल बी इक्वल टू ए डी इंटू डी सी. ओके, सो नाउ द 14th MCQ. इन ट्राइंगल ए बी सी एंगल बी इज 90 degree, बी डी परपेंडिकुलर हाइपोटेन्यूस ए सी. सो क्विकली लेट मी ड्रॉ अ स्मॉल डायग्राम फॉर दैट. तो ये बन गया मेरा ट्राइंगल ए बी सी, वेयर दे टोल्ड मी बी इज 90, देन दे टोल्ड मी बी डी इज अ परपेंडिकुलर टू हाइपोटेन्यूस ए सी. तो ठीक है, अब यहाँ से देखो मैं एक परपेंडिकुलर बनाती हूँ बी डी. नेक्स्ट ए डैश डी डैश सी, यस बिटवीन दिस इज ऑल्सो अग्रीइंग विद अस. नाउ दे टोल्ड मी सी डी इज 2 cm एंड ए डी इज 8 cm, देन बी डी इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच? तो अभी अभी हमने फॉर्मूला सीखा है ज्योमेट्रिक मीन वाला. सो माई फॉर्मूला विल बी बी डी स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू ए डी इंटू डी सी. तो ए डी इज 8, डी सी इज 2, तो आई विल गेट ओवर हियर बी डी स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू 16, 8 2s are 16. सो नेक्स्ट बी डी विल वेरी ईजिली बी 4 बिकॉज आई हैव फाउंड आउट द स्क्वेयर रूट. तो बी डी आया 4, मतलब मेरा ऑप्शन आया बी ऑप्शन. एंड दिस इज हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कम डाउन टू आर ऑप्शन एज बी. फुल solution is in front of you. Okay, so today we have discussed 2 theorem-based, 2 formula, 2 proof-based chapters. We started off with similarity and we gradually shifted on to Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so this is all for today. Thank you for being such a wonderful audience and listening to me so patiently. And before I take your leave, I would like to wish all of you all the very best for your CET exams. Do well, whatever you've learned in these years of your academic career, everything is going to be applied into this. So just focus, keep your calm and come out with flying colors and make everybody proud of you. Okay, so bye everybody, take care, all the best. And before I take your leave, a last statement to be told to you. Kindly subscribe to our channel, like, share, and please give it maximum mileage. Okay? Thank you everybody. Bye-bye.